And I'd just like to introduce Lorraine Strathie from PPRI Sadara, who is going to talk to us about current and prospective agents of Parthenium hysterophorus.
Afternoon, everyone. You've already heard a couple of the speakers already mentioning Parthenium, and it's gaining more attention as the plant increases its spread and abundance in South Africa. For those of you who are not familiar with it, it's Asteraceae, grows up to about 2 meters in height, has a prolific seed production, and is allelopathic, so it can outcompete native vegetation. And it's becoming very problematic in Africa. It affects crop production, various crops, also animal production, grazing land, fallow lands, roadsides, watercourses. It impacts in areas that have biodiversity significance. It also occurs around, if you're in the northern parts of KZN, these are some of the rural houses that are completely surrounded by seas of Parthenium, and around clinics and schools, and it has health and implications for both animals and humans, causing respiratory and dermatitis. Biological control has been successfully used in Australia, and in South Africa we've been considering a suite of different agents using some of the research that's been done in Australia. These affect different parts of the plant, the leaves, the seeds, the stems, and the roots of the Parthenium. And last year, the first insect agents were released for this weed. The first of these was a stem-boring weevil. It lays its eggs in the flowers, it tunnels in the stems, the larvae tunnel in the stems of the pith. From July onwards, we've released about 4,000 weevils at 30 different sites in KZN and in Mpumalanga, where the weed is most prolific. The leaf-feeding beetle Zygogrammma is the second agent that was approved for release in 2013. It defoliates the plants, so both the larval stage and the adults can completely defoliate the plants. And over 10,000 beetles have been reared and released in KZN and Mpumalanga at 60 different sites, and that's the first summer of releases. And this agent has also been provided to Tanzania. Several thousand have been provided there for release there. In February, we monitored some of these release sites, about 80 of them, and in KZN and Mpumalanga, we see the presence. Zygogrammma, the leaf feeding beetle, was present at more than 50% of the sites, and listronotus, the stem boring weevil, was present at about 45% of the sites in KZN and all of the sites, release sites in Mpumalanga. So those are pretty good figures for the first summer of releases. Looking at the data, you can see that we found for Zygogrammma, the leaf feeding beetle, we found eggs, larvae, and adults in the field. Some of the sites we didn't find anything, but some of them we found several hundred or 100 odd beetles just within a 30-minute period. And we would expect those numbers to increase with time. So some of the sites, particularly in Mpumalanga, we were seeing complete areas of about 30 meters by 30 meters completely defoliated by the Zygogramma beetles, and this is far more than was expected at this stage, and was far better than the results that were achieved in Australia during the first season. So these are really encouraging. The stem boring weevil, the adults are nocturnal, they're also quite cryptic, so we don't expect to see them in the field. However, we can look for these little black marks on the flowers as indications of eggs, and at one of the sites we found over about 1,000 eggs just in a 30-minute period. So some of the sites are really, they're showing good signs of persistence there. So at some sites we were finding like stems that are completely being fed on here, and multiple plants. So we're really, really encouraged by these signs. It remains to be seen how these agents will persist through the winter period, And by the next spring and summer, if they're still persisting at those sites, then we can confidently say that they have established. But we're encouraged by these first results. We also have several other agents that we're working on in quarantine. The first of these is a seed-feeding weevil. The larvae develop inside the seeds. Each flower has 5 seeds, and the larva completely destroys the seeds. No choice tests that we conducted have shown that this agent has laid no eggs on any of the non-target species that we assessed, 39 different Asteraceae species and several sunflowers, and that it's host specific. And we will be applying for permission to release this agent after we've done impact trials. So we expect, hopefully by next summer, that we would have permission to release this agent as well to add to our suite. Another agent that we've considered is a stem galling moth. It's very damaging. The larvae create these galls on the stems. It was very damaging and widespread in Australia. It's probably one of the most damaging agents there. It also uses other species, ambrosia and xanthium. And in India, it was also found that it used gazotia abyssinica, which is a oil seed crop that's very important there, as well as in Ethiopia. So that's where we started our assessments. We've assessed 5 different cultivars from Ethiopia. And the first stage of results we got were that we got larvae, galls and adults on the non-target species, which is not great. However, multiple choice trials showed that there were larvae and galls that were formed, but these were significantly fewer than on the Parthenium plants, so it is less preferred. However, when we looked at larval development and monitored this on, assessed this on the Parthenium versus the Gazotia cultivars, we saw that there was galling and adults were formed on all 5 cultivars of Noog, and the development time on these different cultivars and on Parthenium was very similar. So obviously it is a suitable host. However, we've now terminated this culture, and it remains to be seen. Well, we're going to try, because it's such a damaging agent, we feel that it's important to make sure that these host range issues are fully evaluated. And we may be considering open field choice tests in Australia with gazotia to try and further tease out these results and see if under a natural situation these kind of laboratory results would play out in the field. The new agent that we've recently imported is a root crown boring moth. It was slow to establish in Australia. However, this year we found it was very widespread, it was abundant, it was damaging, and it occurred in a variety of different conditions, in dry and isolated plants, small, older plants, and we've now imported a culture and we're starting to assess its suitability. Its root crown, it bores down to the root crown, so this is all the other agents have looked at the leaves and has affected the leaves and the stems and the seeds of the plant, but this one affects the root crown, so the larva actually pushes frass out of there, and then the adult then emerges out of there. In Australia, Parthenium biocontrol was conducted during the 1970s to 2000s, and during that time they've established 9 different agents on the plant, and these are very successful under different habitats and in different seasons. And in what we saw in April this year was that although there was Parthenium present in central Queensland and Australia, and there were some dense areas, most of the areas that we travelled in that were in core infestation areas a couple of decades ago had very small plants. The infestations were very patchy. And we were really impressed and saw that biocontrol definitely has had a significant reduction in the extent and the density of the plant, and to the extent that the farmers in central Queensland now have downgraded the plant from what was the most important weed in the area to about the 5th most important or even lower in ranking. And these are some of the sort of sites we saw. So you can see that most of these plants, although there's an infestation there, it's at sort of knee level height, about 0.5 meter or so. And this is in comparison in South Africa, where Saki is like basically being towered over by Parthenium. So yeah, we can hopefully get to levels like this. We will continue with pre- and post-release research. We've got efforts to measure the agents, and those need to be coordinated as more and more agencies get involved. The releases do need to be coordinated. We need secure sites. Some of the sites have been cleared. There's also a variable site suitability. So some of the areas get very dry, and that needs to be taken into consideration. And we do expect that the agent performance will be variable in different areas, but however, in the long term, we do expect considerable impact of biocontrol agents on Parthenium. So in conclusion, we've got two insect agents that we're releasing. They're both persisting and showing good signs of damage in the first season. There's a seed feeding weevil that's going to be hopefully released within the next season. And there's a new root crown boring moth that's been imported that we'll be assessing. And so there's sustained funding and impetus for biocontrol research and implementation over the next few years. And biocontrol is now being integrated into national and provincial strategies. There's a national strategy for Parthenium that's being developed. And it's basically, biocontrol is very critical for the sustainable long-term management of Parthenium. Thank you.